Our next speaker for the day is Mr. Dheeman Mukherjee, Director, Marketing Solutions, LinkedIn. Dheeman's team is helping brands connect with your audiences through LinkedIn's comprehensive marketing solutions, be it LinkedIn audience targeting using media formats such as content ads, social ads, partner messages, or building communities on company pages and custom groups, or getting insights using LinkedIn polls, LinkedIn answers, and LinkedIn brand perception study. Mr. Dheeman Mukherjee.
Hi, are we expecting more people? Okay, so we can get started. Thank you for coming in today. I'm glad to be here in ISP. It's my first visit to the campus, pretty incredible campus, I must say. Today I'm going to talk about social media and how B2B marketers are leveraging social media. Yeah, there's a lot happening on social media right now. We all know, we are all part of this ever-growing social media space. One of the fundamental things that is happening is that as marketers, as users, we are taking, making sense of what's really happening here. Social media has fundamentally changed the way we think, we act, we respond to people, and so on and so forth. One of the things that I want to talk about social media in particular is the fact that, information is being created, disseminated, shared in ways that nobody could, comprehend, let's say, 15 years back. News now breaks first on social media and then on other channels. So we are all aware of all of that. What does it mean for marketers like you? People are talking about your brand. People are talking about products and services. Are you in control of all of this? All of that, so much of data is being shared. Are you in control? That's the fundamental question that as marketers you need to really take control of. It's a changing world of work, people are, associating with companies and they're choosing to use social media to gather information about companies. You talk about 15 years back, you had very little, probably you'll go to the website of the company and figure out what's happening. But now there is enough and more data available to you on social media to really make a more informed decision about that company, and basis what people are saying, what brand advocates are saying about your brands, and therefore make the right conclusive decision in terms of how you want to engage with that brand. So make the right choices. So this, again, as a marketer, gives you food for thought, because are you there where these conversations are happening? Are you in control again? So that's something which is thought-provoking. Talking about the work culture, let me ask you in this room, how many of you are probably, changed jobs maybe two or three times at least? I mean, how many, just a show of hands? Most of you, I guess. So when I look back, to my father's time, my father worked with one company. And that's probably true with your father, your uncles, aunts, whosoever. So the job economy, the work economy has changed. And it has changed to an extent where we know that, people are no longer working to make a living. They're working because they love their work. And when you talk about love for work, people want to experiment with different kinds of professions. The career graph is no longer looking linear. The career graphs are very, very complex nowadays, as you branch out into so many other ways of making your professional choices. So when you talk about social media, again, the social media actually gives you the benefit of choosing the kind of companies you want to work with. Again, when I talk about building your career graph, your reputation or your own how people want to perceive you is something that is of paramount importance. So when you talk about your career or your professional graph, it should look good. And so that is again something that social media is helping you do. So it's not about only fun and frolic, It's about having fun at work. It's not only about making a living out of your profession. So at the end, you know, if I connect the dots, it's about relationships, and relationships do matter a lot in the present world. So when I'm talking about, you know, if I think about the way people are choosing to relate to companies, there is an emotional bond at times. You know, when you talk about products and services, about brands, people are emotionally connecting to your brand. So we have very many cases of marketers who approach us and say that, you know, we have a presence on LinkedIn and we never knew that. So it's important that you take control of these kind of situations. The third very important thing that I want to talk about is the way you want to measure your presence on social media. You know, we've had several instances in the past where people have you know, gauged the success of their campaigns online by, you know, a very binary kind of a call to action, which could be a cost per click or a cost per download or whatever. With social media, there has been a paradigm shift. And I want to talk about relationships here. It's no longer about having, having a presence alone. It's about building those relationships with the people who matter as far as your brand is concerned. So talking about measurement, you know, now it has gone to an extent where social media is enabling you to figure out how engaged are people, are the audiences that you care for when it comes to your own brand. A lot of you may have heard about Net Promoter Score. That's something that LinkedIn specializes in, and it helps you, you know, achieve metrics like, you know, as to how engaged are people with your brand. Are they likely to recommend your brand to their peer groups? Are they watching your brand favorably? Are there any disconnects that you want to take care of? So all of that can be ascertained nowadays. So things have moved on from the binary call to action that used to be, you know, the sole way of measuring your success online. Now, when I talk about the social networking space, there are broadly three players that come to my mind, so, and probably to everyone's mind. There's Facebook, there's LinkedIn, and there's Twitter. Facebook is a tool where you actually, you know, go ahead and it's about your family, your friends. You have a lot of fun on Facebook. You do things which are off work, off your profession. So when you're talking, you're in a lighthearted mood, that's when you go on to Facebook. While LinkedIn is all about managing your professional identity, it's about gaining insights from what people are saying about you, or about your brands, or the domain that you are associated with. Similarly, Twitter is all about public communication. It is possibly one of the best tools when it comes to disseminating information or broadcasting yourself or your company. What is now happening is that the lines between personal and professional are, you know, sort of blurring. So what do we do? As a marketer, you have to understand that, you know, when it comes to the choice of social media, you have to understand that so the context and relevance are the two pillars that you have to look at. What do you want to do? What do you want to achieve? What is the kind of audience that you are going after? And therefore, choose the right media vehicle, which could be either of the networks that I just spoke about. Talking about LinkedIn, well, we have about 187 million members now worldwide, and we've kind of added 4 million members every month. That's huge numbers. We are no longer a niche channel. We are a mass channel by any stretch of imagination, and we add 2 members every second. So that's incredible. Coming to our mission statement, and this is something that we take very, very seriously. It's about connecting the world's professionals and making them productive and successful in whatever they're doing. So when I actually talk about this mission statement, every you know, every discipline of LinkedIn, whether be it the product team, be it the sales team or the marketing teams or the communications team, they take this very, very seriously, especially, you know, getting products which are aligned to our mission statement. I'm going to talk about a little in detail later on. But what is it fundamentally different that we are doing? It's about your identity. Take control of your identity. LinkedIn is your passport to the professional world. Are you managing your identity well? So when you talk about your identity, you know, maybe think about the last business meeting that you did. You probably went on to Google or, you know, searched the person, and the first link that you probably saw was the LinkedIn link about that person, which led you to get more information about that person, so that you can understand how you are connected to him. Are there any common people who connect you to that person? So all of that really helps you manage your professional world. Also, talking from a career standpoint, I mean, it's possibly the best place where you can have your professional information stored, and it's dynamic. So we've kind of taken charge of your professional identity in that sense as well. The other thing that we are really doing well, and this is something that we are focusing big time, is insights. Now, we all know that there is a fire hose of information, data, analytics, which is being thrown at you at the speed of light. You know, it's very difficult, therefore, to make sense of what's really happening on the social media scenario at this point in time. How do you make sense of all of this? At LinkedIn, we take this very, very seriously. We have a product team which is actually, you know, engineering products which help you get insights from the host of data that is being thrown at you by, you know, people who are connected to you on your network. So that's really the core of how we define engagement. Talking about publishers, you know, we have 1 million plus publishers who are associated with us. So when you talk about gaining insights, again, you know, there is a host of publishers who are associated with LinkedIn, who are either using our developer platform to disseminate information to various people who matter to them. Again, everywhere, this is a very important part. None of us are now, you know, sitting on our desk and chair doing our jobs. Most of us are business travelers. We're traveling day in, day out. So how do we make sure that there are no limitations or boundaries when it comes to getting the right set of information, you know, in professional